Yes. Also, grab a drink and a snack. Maybe some Valium while you're at it, because I'm pretty excited about today's video. My lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. Today I am playing with some new goodies, and I am talking about 10 channels that I watch when I am not watching makeup. If you are new, hi, my name is Nikki, I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I love makeup. I love everything about it, truly. I love buying it, especially. I love reviewing it. I love playing with makeup and combining colors that you don't see every day. So if that sounds like something that you can vibe with, if you want to know how to be fabulous in your 40s and up, if you want to learn how to work with color, or maybe you just want some inspiration about different color combinations, then make sure you are subscribed, because I would love to have you as part of my nestling family. I am going to try and apply makeup while talking about the 10 channels that I watch when I'm not watching makeup. However, this is also a collab video, and that is why I'm so excited. This is a collab video with my friend Angelica Nykvist. You will all know her, I'm sure of it. Especially if you love color, you will know Angelica, right? If you don't know Angelica though, I will leave her channel down below, and I will also leave her video down below. I have quite a few channels that I watch outside of the makeup community, and I thought it would be fun to talk about that. And I know that Angelica loves gaming and loves fashion as well, so I was like, maybe she would want to collab, because I think this could be a very, very fun idea. I asked her and she said yes. So now we're kind of YouTube married. Or something like that. But yeah, it was her idea to do it in this format. So I'm going to try it as well by putting makeup on my face and talking about stuff. So let me grab my list of channels, oh no, that I'm going to talk about, and hope that my editing me won't kill me in my sleep, because I want to be fancy and add some b-roll so that you can see what I'm talking about. Also, I have done my foundation and my brows, because I have some new things that I want to play with today as well in the video. And yeah, the first thing that I actually got is this KKW contour stick, so I thought let's try that first. Yes, let me get a brush. So let's see if I can. Oh, wow, that's nice. That's a nice color. And I've heard that this one is great for an olive complexion. So when it was back in stock, I immediately jumped on it. And this is the shade, I think, light medium. And I actually, a lot of the time, just paint it on the brush. This is quite scary for me, actually, to do it like this, because I never do it like this. But let me also, while I'm kind of buffing in this product, hopefully, let me kind of talk to you a little bit about some of the things that I like to watch when I'm not watching makeup tutorials. Basically, I am a very, very creative person. So I love to watch anything that is creative. I even have some fashion channels. Yes, but don't get your hopes up though. Just so you know. Something like that. So the first channel that I'm going to mention is actually a drama channel. Yes, I know, right? But it is not any old drama channel. I am actually subscribed to just this channel for quite some time. And what I like about this most is that it is not specifically just about the drama, but the creator really tries to, I don't know, almost make it a teachable moment as well. I don't know how to explain it. If you watch him, you know what I'm talking about. And yes, it is a him. It is Peter Mon. I have been subscribed to more channels that cover drama in the past, but he's the one that basically stuck, just because of the way that he presents everything. So yeah, that's the first channel that I want to mention, Peter Mon. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put on blush. Yes, let me go to the palette so I can show you the one that it is going to be. This one from Unique Beauty, the Egg Hunt palette. This is PR, and when you guys saw it, you really wanted me to play with it. So I'm going to today. Here's the color story. Maybe I can kind of cram all the mattes at least on my eyeballs. Let's see if we can do that. Let's get some brushes first. Okay, I'm priming my eyes with the Natasha Denona Eye Base. And while I'm doing that and tapping everything in, I'm going to talk about the next topic, and that is fashion. Now, I know that Angelica watches fashion as well, but I don't think that she's watching, well, maybe she is, but I don't know. I think she's watching different fashion channels than I am, because the fashion channels that I'm watching are about period fashion. And I have two channels that I love to watch from that. The first one is Bernadette Banner, and Bernadette is very, very knowledgeable. I think she worked in costume design as well for period costuming. Maybe both ladies do. I actually don't know. Bernadette is very well versed on especially corsetry, and I love corsets. I love the way that they look. If you have, and I learned loads, because what I always thought that I knew about corsets was actually very, very much not true at all. She also designs, she does sewing with me, and it's very, very fascinating to watch, and she's very, very chill. Now the next channel that I'm going to mention is the channel Abby Cox. I love watching her. She has so much spunk, and she's also very nerdy, and she can get lost in the whole period fashion stuff. But she also explains why things are accurate. She compares everything to patterns that she can find from the area she's talking about. It's just so, so fascinating, truly. I am going to go to the shade Treasure Hunt, the yellow. Yellows on me kinda do show up sometimes, and sometimes they don't really. It's just the nature of the beast, I think. This one does show up though, and these are pastels as well, so I'm tapping it on without blending it too much. Okay, the next shade I'm going to go to is the shade called April Fresh. Same brush. I just cleaned it on the microfiber towel that I have here. I'm going to put that next to it. Now, what I also love to watch are dolry paintings. And it's a whole rabbit hole. It's just, once you get into that, or at least I do, I found more and more channels. And there are so many talented dolry painters out there. Now, there are two that I watch a lot. The first one that I found actually was Poppen Atelier. And Poppen is actually Dutch for dolls, and I think that she is she's multicultural. She's, I believe, Russian, and she's living in Belgium. I'm going to go back to the yellow Treasure Hunt, and she's just so, so talented. She does basically beauty dolly paints, I think you can call it, and she is very, very cool to watch. She's very talented. She explains everything that she's doing actually pretty well, and yeah, her talent is just amazing. I love watching her, and what I love as well is that usually she does the dolly paints, and then her mother makes the outfits, which is just, yeah, it's just so cool. Maybe I should have used a lighter base. I think so. I'm going to go next to the shade Do or Die. And die as not as in dying, but in dying as in paint, you know? It's going to go next to it. I don't think you see a lot of difference though. Now, the shade April Fresh, it's too peachy. And I'm going to actually put this shade over. I don't want to say that my skin tone is peachy, because it's not, because it's olive. But it almost eats it up, looks like. I'm just going to grab that shade Do or Die and a little bit more in. And then the shade Treasure Hunt I'm going to pull over. So basically I'm creating the shade that I had there. It's just tone depth. It's too close to my own tone depth. I hope that makes sense. The next shade I'm going to grab is the purple. And then I'm going to go to the bottom with the purple and the blue, and then to the yellow again, and then kind of mix a gradient. That was the idea, at least. Okay, so the next channel that I'm going to mention for doll repaints is Enchantarium, I think. Those are, I believe they are two sisters, and they do more fantasy repaints. So while the Poppen Atelier also does fantasy repaints, but differently. So I like the difference that they have. Both are just amazingly talented. And it's just so cool to see what they can create, you know, and it's still a very, very creative process, and I love to watch doll repaints, truly. So I can highly, highly recommend both channels. Okay, I'm going to go back to the shade Do or Die that I used before, just the same brush to help blend here a little bit. Now, pastels, you should not blend too much because they are already so light, so I'm tapping and blending a little bit in between. I think I should have used a lighter base. That's my mistake, because then they just pop more. It's a black woman-owned brand, so they should work very well on a darker skin tone as well. They should not turn ashy. I'm lightly pulling it into the crease as well, because I want a little bit more definition. Next, I'm going to go to the shade called Bunny Hop, the blue. Then I'm going to go to the yellow called Treasure Hunt. Okay, and then to the shade Jelly Bean, which was the purple. And I want a little bit of that blue. There. To tie everything together. The next shade I'm going to go to is the shade Easter Egg for the outer corner. What I also love to watch are sculpting, clay, dioramas, that kind of thing, you know? So I have a few channels that I watch from that as well. The first one I want to mention is the channel Nerdforge. Now, they are so amazing. They are a couple from Norway, and they're so, so talented. I actually found them because she did a book insert. There's a name for that, but I forgot. Basically, that you can put in your bookcase, and then you have something there. I don't know how to explain. And I think that was Harry Potter. I think they made Diagon Alley, something like that. But they do so many amazing stuff. She's an amazing painter. She also does book bindings. She does so many amazing stuff. Then the next channel that I want to mention is Clay Sculpting. And that he is called Ace of Clay. And it's just that what he do, he makes it look so easy that I'm like, oh, but I can do that. Yeah, no, I cannot. I may be creative. And a lot of the time when I see it, I can kind of make it. But again, it looks so effortless. And I know it's practice. Because if I set my mind to it, I can do it. Not as well as he can, but he has years of experience. So, you know, practice makes perfect. That's what I always say. But still, it's just so, so cool to watch what he creates. It's just, it's amazing. And he creates Halloween-esque stuff. You know, my kind of vibe. Completely, yes. I'm going to go first to Extravaganza. Let's use this dry first. Pretty, but I kind of want to spray it. I don't use a glitter primer because glitter primer creases my shimmer. So I'm just going to spray the shade. So I'm grabbing it on a brush and then I'm going to spray the brush. And then wiggling here. And one side is the blue Easter egg, the other side is this shimmer. I'm just going to flip my brush, and that is how I mix the shimmers. So the next channel that I want to mention, she does diorama, and she does Harry Potter a lot. She is making, right now, she is making Dumbledore's office, and it's just so, so, so cool to watch. And she is making also matchbox dioramas, which are very, very, very tiny. And her channel name is called Darkest Raven Designs. She is, if I'm not mistaken, also Dutch, hearing from her accent. She does a lot of things with cardboard, and it's just not specifically clay. So it's just a different kind of diorama. Now, I also love it when they use epoxy sculpt to craft, but I don't have specific channels for that. No, that's not true. I want to... Let's cheat, because I always do. I'm going to have 11, because I want to mention this channel as well. That's Jack. I recently found him, but he does sculpting, and he does those epoxy resin dioramas basically. It's just so freakishly cool to watch. Oh Lord, it's just such a talent when you see that. It's just insane to watch, truly. I'm going to go next to Hide Nor Hair because I want to have used it with a. Let's just use this brush because it's okay. I'm going to use a dry and I'm going to put it here on the border of the previous shade. It's a very, very pretty shade, this. It's like a caramelly brown. Okay, next shade I'm going to go to is the shade 24 Karat. It's going to go here. What? Oh yes, pretty. Yeah, I have two channels left, which are nail art channels. One uploads very regularly, the other one, I don't know, once a month or something. But when she uploads, I do watch, so I did want to mention her. So the first channel that uploads regularly is V Nail Edit. And she just does very, very long nails, but it's very interesting to watch. I learn a lot from watching people do their nails, and I get very much inspired. Now, she does a lot of charms on the nails as well. That's not my vibe. I cannot function with that, but I do really like the creative process of it. So I love to watch it because of that. On my lower lash line, I'm going to go to the shade Extra Fragranza first for there, and then I'm going to go to the shade The Happening for more in the inner part. I don't know if I want, I think I want a bright yellow pencil, but I'm not sure yet. So let me first do this. This shade reminds me a little bit of a Super Shock because it's a little bit almost oily in the pan. Oh, I'm going to pick out an eye pencil. That can take 10 minutes, so I will see you when I have done that because I have a new liner and I have some new lashes and I have a new lippy. So let me first pick out an eye pencil. I think that's better. Finally, I found an eye pencil. I went with a yellow one, and I need some spicy lips. Well, yeah, never mind. I just put on the Viper from Nabla. I love that stuff. But the pencil that I put is in my waterline is from LA Girl Shockwave Neon in, what is it, Screamin'? It's my most used. It's very, yeah. Okay. I forgot that I also have this, which is a loose pigment from Madage Beauty in the shade Celestial Stardust, or it's a Celestial Stardust in the shade Magic Star. I don't know. But it is a very pretty goldeny one, and I thought that I could try that one as well. I can also use this for my nails, by the way. I could use it as a highlighter as well, especially in summer. Oh, maybe I can do it right now because why not? Let me get a brush. Where is the brush that I want? It could be a bit too dark though, but let's buff it on my cheek actually. That's actually very pretty. Oh, so I can use it like that as well. Oh, that's nice. Yes, and then grab a bigger brush and just make sure that I buff it in a bit. I actually think that's cutesy. Is that cutesy? I think it is. So yeah, another use for this. So basically I can use it for in a corner. I can also use it for kind of a highlighter blush topper. If you are of a darker complexion, I think this would look gorgeous on you as a highlighter. But I think it looks gorgeous on me as well. And I'm not, oh, very dark. Well, maybe my innards are. Never mind. Did I use all the shades? I did, right? Yeah, what else do I have? I have one channel to mention also. So let me do that first before I'm going to try and put on eyeliner. The last channel that I want to mention is also nail art. And her name is Emily Susanna. She doesn't upload every week, but I think she uploads once a month or something like that. But every time she uploads, I want to watch her. I think she's very talented. I think she's fun to watch as well. And I don't know, she's just basically, she's kind of like me in that stuff happens. So, you know, and she shows it. So when something goes wrong, or if she makes a mistake, you know, or does not really know how to work with a product because she reviews nail sets as well, she shows you as well. And she's very honest about that. And I really, really appreciate that because let's face it, we ain't all perfect. It is my middle name. No, it's not. I don't have a middle name. But yeah, so those are all the channels that I wanted to mention today. Now I am going to try and put on eyeliner. However, I have to be in the mirror with my face, because otherwise I cannot see what I'm doing. So I'm going to do that. I also have two new pairs of falsies, so I'm going to pick out one. Both are from Primark, and this is in the style... these are baby doll lashes in the style 723, which are very cute. And then these are the 3D Allure in... Oh, they are in Allure, 3D, in Allure. I don't know, but this is what they look like. So maybe a little bit more natural. I actually think I'm going to grab these. But I also want to try these. I'm going to see which ones I want to use. I also have two lippies. I think I'm going to do this one. Or am I going to do... I'm probably going to do this one. Yes. So, let me do that. And... then I will be back and I will give you my thoughts on basically the stuff that I am trying out right now. This is the final look of the video. And I like it. I feel pretty. I need to go to the grocery store later and I'm going to go be my fabulous self as always. Let me go over what was new very, very quickly. I hope at least. The KKW stick. Yeah, I think that the color is spot on. And this was indeed the color that I wanted and that I was looking for. It is cool toned, but not so cool toned that it turns purple or gray on me. I love the shade. And I think that the formula is nice. It was nice to work with. I don't know. Yeah, I'm going to work with it more. You will see it a lot popping up on my channel, just saying. And I'm going to do a compare swatch video between what I have and this one, because I think it will be very, very interesting. I haven't decided yet. Yes, let's do that. The Egg Hunt palette. Yeah, it is basically the formula that I'm used to from her. This shade is a duochrome, a little bit of a flakier one. This is also a duochrome, but a little bit more... not as flaky, a little bit more smaller particles. And I'm covered in the stuff. Then this is a normal shimmer, but very pretty. And this is a normal shimmer. This is also kind of a... not specifically, I want to say a duochrome, but more along the lines of you have... a different base and then a different shimmer in there, if that makes any sense. Let's go to the mattes. The yellow shows up on me and it stays. So that is good, because usually yellows don't do that. This shade I need to use either on its own or I need to use it on a lighter primer, because tone depth wise this is too close and it fades away, or at least that's how I feel when I look at myself in the mirror. I can see it, but I can see it because I basically used these two shades and kind of mixed them together a little bit. So that is just the nature of a shade color wise like this. For me, if I use a color like this, I should have grabbed my ABH base, because it's way lighter and then this would have popped. Yes, they are not chalky color wise, if that makes any sense. So when I look at them, I don't see that kind of a gray cast that a lot of pastels have. I don't see that here, so that could be good information, I think, at least. Then the rest of the shades, yeah, this was very easy to work with. This was very easy to work with, and I like this shade of blue a lot. Overall, I think that the palette is the quality that I'm used to from her. Yeah, I think it's still... I made a mess. I think it's still in stock. If I'm not mistaken, it's still in stock, and I will link it down below. I also have an affiliate code with Unique Beauty that will be listed down below as well. Lippy, I think it's pretty. I thought it was a matte. It hasn't dried down, but that is, I think, because I put it on top of the lip viper from Nabla and I didn't blot my lips. So it's a little bit more movable, but it does appear to have a little bit of a sheen in it, which I like. I will keep on trying most stuff. Oh yeah, the falsies. Yeah, I like the falsies. What can I say? I love me my falsies. That's going to be it for today. I hope it was entertaining. Don't forget to check out Angelica's video. And I cannot wait to see all the pics that she has. I'm just so curious to see the channels that she's watching when she's not watching a makeup related content. I'm very, very curious. And Angelica, thank you so much for collaborating with me. I had a blast planning this, filming this, and just chatting with you off camera as well. Yeah, thank you so much for saying yes to little old me. I feel very, very honored. Yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. This is going to be it. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.